types of hickory trees. And in my opinion, this is the easiest one to identify. This is called a shag bark hickory. As you can see, you can tell where it gets its name, shag bark hickory. So if you ever wondered about your axe handle or your tool handle that's made out of Tennessee hickory, this right here's where they come from. Steep walking up this ridge here, but I finally found some white oak trees. I was thinking there might be some white oak here. There's a lot of white oak in this area. Looks like I'm having to work for it today to go up here and take a look at it, but see what we got. This is a good white oak tree. Nice and straight. I'm out of breath. I'd say the diameter is probably 20 plus inches. I'll measure it here in just a second. I thought I saw a burr. There's a very large burl on the back of this tree. Right there. It's a good white oak tree. It's seen its better days. There's a lot of signs of this tree's probably dying. It's lost most of its canopy already. Be a good time to harvest this tree before you lose it. Right up here behind the white oak, we got another shag bark hickory. A lot smaller than that first one. Good tree. About 30 feet up here behind it. Probably the nicest white oak this farm has to offer. This part of the farm, at least. There's a big white oak tree right there. See, at least 28 or 30 inch diameter on that one easily. It's a real nice tree. Now we're up here on top of this little ridge line. Got more shag bark hickory, several of those. They reseeded very well in this area and grew. There's a whole lot of them. Another nice, smaller but nice, black walnut tree. It's a really tall one. And up behind it, we have another white oak. Well, I got to the very top and we're looking down on the other side and there's plenty more walnut trees. This is always good to find when you look for timber. A lot of walnut trees. And straight ahead, if I can zoom in, right there, it's an American beech tree. Very smooth on the outside. Easily to identify those as well. Beech tree. Quarter saw beech tree, and you got yourself a nice workbench top. And if you make a wooden hand planes, right there is an ideal wood for making hand planes. Well, here's what's left of a tree. Who knows what happened to it? Probably just rotted and fell in that ravine behind us. It was a white oak, and judging by the looks of what's left, this thing was huge. This right here is a very big tree. You talk about old growth timber, well, this right here is what that is. This is a white oak. This thing is massive. Let's get a reading here with the spencer tape and see what the diameter is. Feet on the diameter. This is the biggest white oak that I think I've ever seen around here. 15 feet is the diameter of that. Or the circumference, rather. The diameter, we'll have to figure that out in a minute. But that's the circumference of it, is 15 feet. This is a nice tree. Let's spent all the time I got today to look at this timber. I think I looked at the best parts of it. There's a lot more left here to explore, but it's a pretty nice weather today, so I think I'm going to go home and start the Woodmizer up and do some sawing.